So, I don't feel like I put in the effort necessary to get the things that I want. I woke up this morning and I was just like, dog, you seen a kid who couldn't walk and he got up and he's bodybuilder. Have you really been putting in the effort to get back on that basketball court, to be a bodybuilder? And like to find a career path, like, have you really even put in the effort to even do this social media thing? And I'm like, I could always be doing more. I feel like I just been focusing in on my body, just getting it loose from all that pain and all that history that I put it through, the traumas. And that's really what I'm focused on right now. And like, I want to do so much more. And I wish I would have done it earlier to get my body loose. But man, this has really caused me to like stop what I'm trying to do. And but I'm working towards it. I'm working towards getting out of it, but it's like so sluggish. It sucks so bad today. But I know that I need to put more effort. Like, I'm looking at myself I'm thinking about the gym. I'm walking to the gym right now. And I'm like thinking to myself before I started walking, I'm like, dog, have you really put in the effort for legs to not feel so wobbly? Have you put in the effort to like really get your ankles together? Have you really put in the effort to like get your, like, did you hit the things that you needed to hit to really get yourself to be where you're trying to be or where you say you can be? And I'm like, no, because I'm afraid of the pain, but because I've done so much of it already. But like, is that an excuse? Should I just one time just make myself like really feel the pain, or am I doing it just right? These are the dilemmas that you have when you're rebuilding your body and doing things in life, I guess. Like, you're just always second guessing yourself, but you got to keep on chipping away at it. And that's just, this is just how I think about the gym. And I'm thinking to myself, if I want to get back on this basketball court, I got to do more than what I'm putting out right now with working out, just to get my body to feel comfortable being uncomfortable. To think about the extra squats or the stretching. And I've already taken 3 years, 3 whole years to stretch this body out and like get it, try to get it back to even get it to where it's feeling now. And it's like, it's not enough. Man, no way, shape, or form am I down about it. It's just like, what am I really working for? That's the question. What am I really working for? Am I ever gonna achieve what I'm looking for? But I know that if I just keep chipping away, that I'm gonna get the results that I'm looking for. And it may not get me what I want, but it'll get me in that atmosphere. It'll get me in that universe. So that's the goal. And that's what I say I stay focused on every day. No matter how stupid I feel, no matter how hard how sore I feel, no matter how down I am or how much energy I don't have, I'm just always trying to stay positive about this whole thing. And just like I tell myself, just get to the gym because so-and-so's at the gym. Just like, you know what I mean? You gotta have fans. You gotta have people that you're a fan of, and keep that as your motivation to get to the gym every day. Like, I don't care. I've always done this in my mind. I've had a girlfriend at the gym or a couple like wives that I just call them in my head. I call them my wives or whatever have you. And it just gets me to the gym, you know? Hello guys, have a good walk. Thank you so much. No, I just try to get anything. I don't talk to these people. I don't tell them, you know what I mean? I say every once in a while, like if I feel comfortable, if they keep walking to the water machine when I walk over there, or you know, if they're getting, you know, spraying off the machine or going, you know what I mean, going to get paper to spray off the machine, if they're right there a couple times throughout a couple of workouts, a couple of days, a couple of weeks, a couple of months, then I'll say something. But I don't want to impede on somebody's, you know, comfort there when they're in their zone, because I know how it is for me. Like, I get it all the time. The kids or somebody will come by and make sure that they stand right in front of the mirror where I'm looking at, or, you know, you'll be off in the corner just chilling, and somebody will come over there, and like, I don't want to impede on anybody. That's just my proper gym etiquette, and not everybody understands that. And plus, I'm telling myself, you're a Planet Fitness, bro. You can't expect everybody to understand, like, a bodybuilder. They just look at you like, and they just want to see what you're doing. They want to, you're like a celebrity. So, and I smile about it. It just tests my patience. To telling me where I've gotten with my maturity that I've been working on. And also, I wouldn't even say maturity. I would say more like it's, you know, the body pains. But I appreciate you guys coming for this walk with me. We're almost there. But it usually takes me 17 minutes to get to the gym. Yeah, so I haven't walked in a while. I want to test the body out. I want to see where the body is. And if I'm tired when I get back. The goal is to make the muscles and the body as tired as it possibly can, so that the next day or week, it doesn't feel that same way. So stressing the muscles out, trying to force them into walking the proper way, every step, it hurts. Trying to keep my back straight. It really sucks. I need to get off this phone, because the phone got my neck, you know, looking down, and that messes up my neck. But it messes up my back. But I just want to stay as positive as possible about this whole process. It's a process. The process isn't done with you until it's done with you. You can't tell the process when it's over. I mean, you could kind of force it if you're working harder, but it really is up to the process, especially since I haven't really been mobile like I'm trying to be in years. So scar tissue, you know, plantar fasciitis, tendonitis, arthritis, all that stuff is set in, and we just gotta work it out. And we're doing this without massages and all that stuff too. If I had massages, I'd probably definitely be a lot better off than where I am right now. I'm gonna just take the long way. But it is what it is. We're gonna get there. And we're gonna do it natural. You're gonna watch me do this. If you haven't, look back at my past stories and videos. I kind of explained to you like all the issues that I've had. And man, if you're dealing with ailments, do me a favor, just face them, please. Just face them. Go through it, suck it up, do what you love. But the things that you love will cause you pain just as much as the things that you hate. So it's up to you which route to take. That's a bar. Yo, man. It's a beautiful Sunday in San Diego, or Chula Vista, San Diego, California. I'm walking my butt to the gym. What time is it? It's 10:07. Walking to the mall right now. Whew, man, my legs are whooping my butt. My calf will not loosen up. But we're gonna go work on some calves, do some squats, force that muscle to loosen up. But it's only tight because it's weak. So, no matter how much work I've been putting in, it's not enough to get it back to the zero point where it can handle my balance. But we'll get there. We will get there. Honestly, I feel like I got a whole other year before. This is my last one. Morning to you. So, I feel like this is my last year of this pain. Because I'll be able to maneuver how I want. What's this, once I figure out what the heck is this thing on my, in my heel. But anyway, about to walk into this gym. I miss iron weights, man. I miss real iron heavyweight where I gotta. But anyway, about to walk into this lab. That was a good walk. Nice, nice walk. All right, y'all.